Hey, it's Golden Buddha here, back with some more RPG horror stories for your listening entertainment. And today we have a story titled, Haven't You Ever Seen Jurassic Park? And it's pretty crazy. Yeah, let's just go ahead and dive right into it. Roll post. The Party, with names changed. Me, forever DM since 2009. I try not to be an adversarial DM, but I run combat as an extension of RP. Which means that smart creatures fight really smart, and if something is really out for blood, the party needs to approach carefully, running this game over Roll20. Josh, close friend of mine, and a very chill dude, newish to tabletop RPGs but learning quickly, playing a beliefling, a tiefling cleric. Dana, close friend of mine and a very chill lady, roleplay aficionado, but mostly used to games like Fate, playing a half-orc bard. Gary, most experienced D&D player out of the five of us. Not present for this session since he's at DundraCon. His elf rogue is temporarily handed over to Dana. Gabe, the odd one out. Constantly angry and incapable of using a tone other than obnoxiously sarcastic. Imagine any angry nerd reviewer type character, except it's his actual personality and not something he puts on for videos. Close friend of Dana's, and this story's that guy. Playing a half-elf ranger. As a bit of background information, the local trade guild hired the party to secure a logging site that was being menaced by some strange creatures. Unbeknownst to the characters, but suspected by the players, these creatures are long extinct dinosaurs that have been resurrected by a dryad whose tree was cut down by the loggers. In the previous session, the players had a nasty run-in with a Quetzalcoatlus, basically a giraffe with a razor-sharp beak, a 35-foot wingspan, and a bad attitude. They got torn up a bit trying to fight in the open, where it could take full advantage of its abilities, but got smart and hid in a dense grove and drove it off with spells. I was hoping this signaled to them that they need to be careful and think tactically. Their first combat encounter of this session is a pack of velociraptors. These aren't the ones that appear in Jurassic Park, since those were based on the Deinonychus. Rather, these raptors are quite small and rely on their flanking abilities to do any real damage. The party handles these pretty well, and despite some sneaky tactics, the velociraptors are unable to get real advantage by flanking the party. I took this as a good sign, which was apparently a mistake on my part. Some fluff, RP, and treasure hunting later, the party comes across the encounter. A solo Deinonychus, which spots the party and then darts deeper into the forest, squawking the whole way. Remember when I said the velociraptors from Jurassic Park were based on the Deinonychus? Yeah, this is that asshole. Stat-wise, they have an intelligence of 4. That might not sound impressive, but that's 1 point higher than wolves, who you probably know in the real world are expert pack hunters that can display impressive tactics. I thought I was running this encounter pretty generously. The Deinonychus runs away from the party, making a ton of noise. Earlier, they had fought velociraptors who communicated with each other to attempt advanced flanking maneuvers. I thought I was signaling to the party that something is up and they need to be careful. The party follows this Deinonychus further into the forest and comes across a huge tree stump with a cavern under its roots. I describe the sounds of digging coming from under the tree stump and make it clear that their Deinonychus friend from earlier is perched on top of the tree stump and watching them like a hawk. I make a couple of rolls visible to the players, although they don't know what the rolls are for. These rolls are the two other Deinonychus, which are hiding in the dense foliage nearby, succeeding on their stealth rolls against everyone's passive perception. Gabe immediately fixates on the digging coming from the cave. Gabe, I'm going to try to sneak into the cave and see what that noise is. Me, are you sure? Sneaking in D&D doesn't work like it does in Skyrim. You won't be able to magically make things that have already seen you forget that you're there. The creature is still watching. That's fine. I want to sneak to the cave. Josh and Dana are hanging back and seem pretty nervous about this approach. Gabe rolls something middling. Without so much as looking around first, he walks closer to the tree stump, leaving about 50 feet between himself and the nervous, genre-savvy party members. All three Deinonychus spring their attack. Deinonychus has a nasty ability that lets it attempt a knockdown when it runs at least 20 feet before attacking. All three Deinonychus are far enough from Gabe to get their pounce attacks. His character saves against the first two, but gets knocked down, and knocked down to negative HP by the third. Gabe loses his shit. He starts to scream and cuss, and then mutes his mic. Combat unfolds. The rest of the party manage to stabilize Gabe's character and take down the dinos. Gabe shows up again, finally, although now he's been gone for about 10 to 15 minutes. Me. Welcome back. The rest of the party stabilized your character, so you're wounded, but Gabe, I'm dead. No, it doesn't work like that. You're only dead if you reach a negative HP corresponding to your maximum HP or fail 3 death saves. No, I'm dead. I fucked up. And I'm dead. Dana and Josh try to back me up and explain that it doesn't work like that, but Gabe continues to mope. At this point, Gabe is actually frightening me a bit, but I keep cool so I can wrap up the session. The party backtracks to make camp in a hermit's cottage and then get back to the cave and finally meet the dryad. Session ends, and Gabe bolts. Gabe is now on probation. I know I should probably kick him out for his stunt, but he's part of a larger social group that often does things together. If this happens again, though, he's gone. Dana likes to excuse his behavior by blaming his anger on the death of his mother several years ago, but literally everyone else in the group has experienced severe trauma at some point, and we managed to keep it together for game night. Gabe needs to be in therapy if he really is having a hard time of coping. The worst part is that now I feel like if anything bad happens to Gabe's character, he's gonna have another breakdown. End post. Too long, didn't read. That guy makes terrible decisions, gets torn up by Jurassic Park raptors, throws a fit. I mean, it sounds like a grand old time. It sounds like Gabe was the only one who had an issue. That sucks that he kind of ruined the session. Outbursts like that, even if it's online, even if it's not like hurting anyone, quote unquote, that's not something you need to put up with, despite them sharing the same social group and circle of friends. Because at the end of the day, you got to say, well, is he making everyone uncomfortable? Like, you have to put concerns of the group before the concerns of this one player, you know, and accommodating for him. You're going to give him another chance. I might just kick him out at that point, because you gave him ample opportunity to make a better decision. You know, you told him, hey, this doesn't work like in Skyrim. If you go out there, he still saw you. The trap is still probably set. So, and he continued along with it and paid the consequence, and then he had a bitch fit. As for the whole his mother died and all that stuff and the sympathy issue, that's something you guys need to talk with him out of game, you know, and ask him about that and be good friends. But again, that's not like a problem you can solve. You know, if you can't solve the problem, you have to get rid of the person who's causing the problem. Point blank, period. That's simple as it gets. I mean, other than that, fighting velociraptors, that sounds fun as shit. You could do the whole hunting in the brush and the whole, like that one guy in Jurassic Park, with clever girl, you know, all that shit. that meme that everyone remembers. Or maybe not. Maybe I just remember it. Yeah, man. I hope it doesn't go like that next time. I hope he's mellowed out a bit, and I hope he's doing okay. And I hope you guys have a great, great session. So, but with that being said, let me know what you think of the story in the comments below. Like and subscribe for more content. And as always, this is Golden Buddha telling you to stay enlightened.